Flowers in the Postbox, a story by Dyer Slavkovich. Nastya met the postwoman at the gate and took the newspaper. The postwoman wiped the perspiration from her brow. "Aunt Marina, don't you find it hard carrying such a heavy bag?"
"And how? See for yourself."
"Why do you have so many newspapers?" asked Nastya.
"Because people subscribe to many. They read a lot so that they'll know more."
"May I help you?" asked Nastya.
"How can you help me, dear girl?
The bag's too heavy for your shoulders."
"I'll walk along the street with you. You'll take the newspaper to one house, I'll take the newspaper to another. We'll do the job faster, and then it'll be easier for you.
Don't go to all that trouble. It'll tire your legs."
"It's nothing."
So they went along together. Aunt Marina went to one house, Nastya to another. They covered the rounds of the whole township in just half an hour. It was fast and efficient. There was only one problem. The post boxes were so high in three of the houses that Nastya couldn't reach them.
"You've been such a great help," said Aunt Marina when they were parting.
"Thank you, my assistant."
From then on, Nastya went to the other end of the town every day. She would meet Aunt Marina at the bridge. The people began to call Nastya Post Girl. She liked that very much.
"Is there only a newspaper for me today?" they asked in one house.
"Only a newspaper, but it's a very interesting one," she answered.
"Any letters, Nastya?" they asked in another house.
"They're still writing them," Nastya joked like Aunt Marina. She was very warmly welcomed by the old lady teacher. The post girl enjoyed dropping in at her house. But on Monday, they had nothing to deliver to the old lady.
"Aunt Marina, why aren't we taking anything to the teacher?"
"Her newspaper doesn't come out on Monday, and there are no letters or magazines for her," said Aunt Marina. Nastya felt very sorry for the old lady. "She's probably sitting and brooding. The post girl hasn't not come today. Must have felt lazy.
Perhaps..."
She gave a start at the unexpected thought.
When they'd finished with the post and Aunt Marina went back, Nastya ran out of town into a field where the flax blossomed and the wheat grew. There were plenty of flowers just for the picking there. Nastya picked some.
On that day, the teacher found a bouquet of wild daisies and cornflowers in her post box. The teacher took the flowers out of the box carefully and lifted them to her face. And her face lost its wrinkles, looked youthful, and broke out in a happy smile.